Traffic is a major concern for Lagosians. Commuting is...
As a global city, yeah, like all global, like all global cities.
So,
yes.
I mean, what are the governor's plans towards easing the situation?
We're easing the situation already. Last year, by the time the administration started, you know, end of May, June, July, that was in the thick of rainy season. Anybody who knows Lagos very well will know that as a coastal, you know, city, you will always encounter a few challenges, particularly during the rain, which is why we always advise, you know, people don't block drainages, don't, you know, do this, be mindful of other road users. And then a few constructions were going on. We acknowledge, of course, that, you know, a number of roads were bad, but what we have done was to respond in good time and effectively to the complaints, to the yearnings, you know, of Lagosians. You see that the inner roads are a major problem. The governor working in sync with the local government executive secretaries, you know, has commissioned 114 inner roads, all belonging to local governments, two per LCDA, which means that by, you know, the middle of this year, 114 roads will have been completed. That will ease traffic, because the more roads you fix, the more roads you rehabilitate and repair, the smoother, you know, driving will become. In addition to that, we, in 8 months, not counting February, which will make it our ninth month at the end of this month, in 8 months of our administration, we have fixed, repaired or rehabilitated a total of 340 roads all across the divisions and senatorial districts of Lagos. Again, the more roads you fix, the better, you know, for traffic. We have also fortified the last mile. We recognize to start with that there was an error of judgment, so to speak, when we felt that last mile should not go all out, you know, to enforce the law. But we saw that a few people took advantage of the compassionate policy of His Excellency the Governor at that time, and we needed to review it, which is what we have done, you know, to listen to the people, you know, to say that don't treat particularly those Okada drivers, you know, your commercial buses, don't treat them with kid gloves. So we are now enforcing the law in full force. Not only that, we have also brought in mobile courts, and so far we have tried more than 600, you know, people. And you see all over Lagos that people now say that the fear of Lagos mobile courts is the beginning of wisdom, because you don't want to get caught on the wrong side, you know, of the law. It is not peculiar to Nigeria. It is what you what needs to be done. Why do Nigerians, for example, stay in Lagos, throw garbage out of the car while they are driving, and then they get to London and
they're looking for a trash can.
Exactly, and they don't do that. It's because they know that the consequence of misdemeanor, you know, will be very dire. That is the message that we are also sending, you know, through the mobile court, because it deals with traffic issues, you know, it also deals with environmental, you know, violations, and really we believe that we have done very well, because not only have we convicted, you know, more than 500 people, twice, if not thrice, the number of people that you are dealing with, you are sending message to them to say that, oh, these people are serious, they're not joking with this, and therefore we should comport ourselves. We notice, for example, you know, from what we're doing with the mobile courts, that in the first 1 week, we the law enforcement officers didn't apprehend anybody taking one way, because they knew that they would be playing with 3 years in jail, you know, and about ₦1 million in fine, or both. And therefore, the message was clear, that people knew that if they were caught, you know, exactly. So that has improved traffic a lot. Well, we need to appreciate the fact that Lagos has the smallest landmass in Nigeria, the highest number of cars and vehicles, and also and people consume the largest 40% of the fuel that we use in Nigeria we consume in Lagos, and therefore you will have to deal with the huge size in a small space. Traffic won't disappear completely, but where we're saying that we can manage it better, particularly with our with the announcement by His Excellency the Governor that by December the light rail, the blue line, will be ready. We're doing a lot of investment on the waterways. We're trying to put a lot more operators there, do a lot more regulation, you know, invest in channelization of, you know, the waterways, so that a lot of people moving from Ikorodu, you know, to the island, to Edo, you know, can, you know, use the waterways rather than, so by the time we're able to effectively take a lot of people off the road, let them use the train services, let them use the waterways, we know that we will have gotten somewhere. But you also have to understand that in a country where one state is about the only state truly working, is the El Dorado.
Yes.
The more great works you do, the more you attract people to come in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, those are the things that we're dealing with. Mm-hmm. Yeah.